Hi everyone. This is a lecture for the students of Institute of Cost Economics of India, intermediate level. And we are going to look at operations management and strategic management subject, chapter 2, operations planning. Under that, demand forecasting using linear equation. So this is for the restricted purpose of the course. So let's get into the topic. So demand forecasting is an important function in any business, whether it's a small shop or a multi-billion dollar giant. Everywhere you need to forecast your sales appropriately to put in place the rest of the forecasting, whether it's raw material required, staffing required, finance required. Everything revolves around what is your sales going to be. So it's a very critical function in any company. People use different methods. This is a mathematical model using linear equation. So I request you to go through the theory in the institute study material, and we'll get into the problem right away. So linear equation, when we say linear equation, you have an X and a Y. So there are two variables, X and Y. And the formula is given by Y is equal to A plus B X. This is the linear equation. And once you find out A and B using the data given in the problem, you can substitute it here. I'll give you what are all the elements. Y is the forecast sales. So X is the time period. So by time period, I mean, in this model, say since it's mathematical, I need to have some base. The base is the sales over the last so many years. We use that as the base to find out what will be my sales in the upcoming year, forthcoming years. So Y is the sales forecast for time T, and X is the time period T. So you will understand this when we get into a problem. So it is given by A plus BX. A is nothing but average sales over the last so many years we have in data. And B is the growth rate or variation for every time period. So the variation is given by sigma xy by sigma x square. See, this is a easier formula, provided you follow a particular step that we'll see in the problem. This doesn't apply to the general linear equation. So expanded version is available. You would have studied in your schools, colleges, but this is a contracted version, subject to you following a particular rule in solving the problem. Let's look at it. So you have your years, financial year ending 31st March 2013, 14, 15, 16, so on till 2020. And the sales for the last so many years. So how many years do we have? We have 8 years. Say probably we'll cut down 1 year on the top. So cut down, say 2014. So this is the year X and the sales Y. As I mentioned earlier, X is normally given to an independent variable, time here in this case, and sales Y is a dependent variable. So we are constructing a time series and trying to forecast the demand for the future. So since we have X and Y, if it's say an expanded version of the problem would include So I just wanted to show you the full formula for this. If you go online, you may find this as the expanded version of the formula. So if you're doing it in Excel, you can use this expanded version. Sigma xy minus sigma x sigma y divided by n, the whole thing divided by sigma x square minus sigma x the whole square by n. This is a formula for finding B. And A, it is sigma y by n minus b sigma x by n. So this is the normal formula. But your book has a shortened version. So let's come back to this equation in a bit. Let's see how to do this. So you have the years and sales. These are x and y. If you use the same numbers, it will become a cumbersome problem. So instead of using this 2014, 15, and so on, we are planning to use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And even if you use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you may have to use this expanded version of the formula. So what should I do? I need to smartly change this number. Say it's a time series. I need to have seven sequential numbers. So it need not start from one. It can even start from minus three in this case. So minus three, minus two, minus one, zero, one, two, three. You keep adding one, one to the first number, you get this. Now, if I do a sum of this, it is zero. What is the sum? This sum is sigma x. Sum of x. If sum of x is zero, then what happens in this place? Since sum of x is zero, here you have sigma x. So sigma x is zero, then this whole thing becomes zero. Similarly, sigma x here, this becomes zero, the whole thing becomes zero. Again here, sigma x by n, so this becomes zero, this whole thing becomes zero. So what are you left with? B is sigma xy by sigma x square, and A is sigma y by n. So this is what we have used here. So this is the formula we are using. B is sigma xy by sigma x square, and A is sigma y by n. So this is sigma x square, not just x square. Okay, so going back to the problem. Now all we need is, in the equation, what all we had? Sigma x was there, sigma y was there. So this is trying to find the symbol. I'll just draw this. So this is sigma y, and then we have sigma xy, and then sigma x square. So let's find all that. Xy is nothing but x into y, and the sigma of that 183, and then x square and the sum of that. So this logic will apply only if the number of items are odd, number of year data is odd number of years. If it's even number of years, say the count is 7 here. If it's even, then we may have to use a different formula or different logic, which will come to in a while. So now that we have the data, so B is equal to, what is the formula? B is sigma xy by sigma x square. B is equal to sigma xy divided by sigma x square. So this is your B. And then A is equal to sigma y by n. So sigma y divided by n is the number of years of data, 7. So y, we have A and B. So which year are we planning to get the data for? Suppose 2021, 2022, 2023. These 3 years are required to be forecasted. Y value for these are, say for 2020, sorry, X value for this, the time value. X value for these years, 2020 was taken as 3. 2019 was 2, 2020 was 3. So 2021 will be 4, then 5 and 6. So you have to substitute this formula A plus BX. Y is equal to A plus B X. So sales will be A plus B into X. So 268, 274, and 281. So nothing but your average sales is 242, and your growth is 6.53 for every year. So for 4 years from the center, you need to have 4 years of growth. So the center is 242 plus 4 years of growth, 4 times 6.53. And the say interesting fact about this is you can do this in Excel automatically. Let me try. So let's take the years out. We have this data. Click design, add. What we did is a linear trend. Format trend line. Display equation. Roughly 216 plus 6.5. Since they are using the series 1 to 7, they'll get a bit of a different number. But the growth rate is 6.53, wherever you started. So we also got the same value. They're also getting the same value. Suppose, I don't know whether I can change this value. I cannot. Okay. So your annual growth is 6.53. since we are starting from 1 to 7, the average is a bit different, because for the 8th year we'll use multiply by 8. So Excel, you can do it in a jiffy. Here we may have to, for examination purposes, you have to do the calculation in detail. Now suppose the number of years is even. So we are starting from 2015. Then what happens? So let the references remain. If I start with -3 here, -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2. 6 years, since the data is given only for 6 years, stops at 2. Then the sigma x becomes -3. You may have to use the expanded version of the formula. So what should I do? I should instead start from -7 and then keep adding 2 to the series. See, all you need is a progression, or -5 probably. Okay, yeah, -5. -5. -3, -1, 1, 3, 5. So what have we done? We are jumping 2 numbers at a time. Earlier we were jumping only 1 number at a time. If the number of years data is even, then jump 2 numbers at a time. So if it's for 6 years, start from -5. If it's 8 years, start from -7. Remember, 6 years, start from -5, and then jump 2 numbers. -5, -3, -1, 1, 3, 5. All we need is a series, number series. So to ensure that sigma x becomes 0, we come up with a different series. That's all. So I have this data, -5, -3, -1, 1, 3, 5. Sigma x becomes 0, sigma y, sigma x square, all these are there. So we have already used formula to calculate these numbers. So y equal to a plus bx, we have the formula. But only thing is, these values, since we are jumping 2 numbers for every year, 2020 is 5. 2021 will be, correct, 2 numbers jumped, 7. Again, 2 numbers jumped, 9. 2 numbers jumped, 11. So when you have even number of years in the data, number of years is 6, which is even, start from -5. So please refer to my handouts as well if you have some confusion, but it's a very simple, straightforward forecasting section. So methodology rather. So I'll meet you again with a different method in the next session. Thank you, everyone.